there is no predictable type of Elvis impersonator. Elvis has universal appeal. There's an Elvis of every color, stripe, and persuasion, every nationality. It is an extraordinary phenomenon. It's unprecedented in world history.
They come from every walk of life. Today, their exact number is unknown, but estimates range from 20,000 to 35,000 worldwide. Elvis Presley is, and will always be, the most impersonated figure in all of history.
Hi, my name is Paul Elvis Butler, and on the 25th anniversary of Elvis Presley's death, we'd all like to say,
good morning, America!
Well, it's one for the money, two for the show. You can get it ready now, go get it for the dough. Never want to quit you. When you're doing it back, you're all my blue chase. If you knock me down, show my face. Slam my name all over the place. You're the lady that you want to do.
And Paul, just one of any number of Elvis impersonators, as you can imagine, who are converging now on Memphis, Tennessee, for the 30th anniversary of the death of the King of Rock and Roll.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Take your word.
How long have you been a fan of Paul Butler's?
About 3 years, three and a half. I think he's number one.
Come back next year?
If Paul Butler comes, yes.
My name's Edith Coleman.
How long have you been a fan of Paul Butler's?
For about 10 years. I think he's number one.
Okay.
Linda Dome from Montclair, Michigan.
How long have you been a fan of Paul Butler's?
We've been coming for 3 years now.
Okay. What's your opinion of Paul?
Paul is great. Paul Butler, number one.
Okay. Hey, ma'am.
My name is Kara.
Okay. How long have you been a fan of Paul Butler's?
Oh, ever since I've been seeing him, probably about 10 years.
Okay. What's your opinion of Paul?
Oh, he's fantastic.
Paul is Elvis, no matter whether he's in his outfit or whether he's in regular clothes. To me, Paul is Elvis.
The original concept for Legends in Concert was to pierce the heavenly veil and go into heaven for a heavenly concert as a tribute to the superstars of yesterday and today. And I said, okay, now I'm going to do the program. I'm going to put now the order of appearance as to the importance of the contribution overall, the magnitude, the magnetism that was created by this person, who should close the show? Undoubtedly, it would be Elvis Presley.
Ladies and gentlemen, Elvis.
Thank you very much. Thank you so much. I'd like to do a song right here from Blue Hawaii, dedicated to all the beautiful ladies out here in the house.
Many Elvis pretenders who come close, and others who just miss the mark. And then there are impersonators who create an illusion of Elvis on stage that is so convincing.
Well, old tall Sally, she is real sweet, she got everything at home, but all needs old baby. Whoa, 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 baby. Yeah, hey, baby, I hope so.
Oh, I got my first album at the age of 4. And at the age of 9, when Elvis did his 1968 comeback, from that moment on, I knew it was going to be a lifetime thing. Well, I don't consider myself an impersonator. I consider myself a tribute to the King of Rock and Roll. A tribute is a person that's given their love and their heart and their soul for many years, and it's something that comes from inside, and it's what makes me different than all the rest. I've never considered myself an impersonator. I've always considered myself a tribute to the King of Rock and Roll, because I don't try to be Elvis. The Elvis in me just comes naturally out, because it's there from the love and the experience and all the years of performing and singing his music. Our age groups are from small to old. They're as young as 3 and 4 years old. And for myself, the 3 and 4 and 5 and 6 year olds is very special to me, because I'm introducing Elvis to a whole new generation. When I'm surrounded by an audience during a show, they're experiencing the excitement and the love for Elvis that he gave to us all. I like to think that when the show is over, that they go home at night thinking that they have experienced a true Elvis show, knowing that the show that they just experienced has the true love for the music, the man, and his legacy that will always be known as Elvis Presley.
Doing a tribute to the King of Rock and Roll, Elvis Presley, for the past 43 years. And it still amazes me today how this one album chose my destiny, changed my life forever. This one album. You see, 50 years ago, at the age of 4, my mother and me walked into a record store, and there it was. This album caught my eye. It was mesmerizing. I wanted it. It was all the gold records on it. Of course, my parents couldn't afford the album, so they told me no. Well, I laid down on the floor and threw a tantrum, screaming and kicking and crying. I was only 4 years old. I didn't know Elvis. But my mom finally agreed to get it for me. And my mother's only stipulation was, I'll buy this album for you, but you're going to have to memorize every word to every song. And of course, I agreed, took it home, and the rest is history.
I could be you, you could be me, for just 1 hour. We could find a way to get inside each other's mind. You could see you through my eyes instead of your ego. I believe you'd be surprised to see that you've been blind. Walk a mile in my shoes. Walk a mile in my shoes. Yeah, before you abuse, criticize, and accuse. Walk a mile in my shoes.
Well, in the beginning, financially, you know, it was kind of rough and kind of hard, you know. I think scarves were like 50 cents a piece to me, and I could give away 10. Compared to today, when I do a two-hour show, I give away about 350, and they cost $2 a piece. You know, I've been doing this for 40 years now. I have a total of 9 CDs, and I'm famously known for giving them away. If you waited till after the show and asked me for one, I'd just give it to you, because it meant more to me to give it to somebody and see the reaction on their face. I felt like they were going to take it home, and they were going to enjoy it so much more. And I really didn't make the albums to get rich or to make money. I made the albums to be remembered, to have something that once I'm gone, it's still here. It marked that I was here and that I'd done that. And to this day, I've done 9 albums and 180 songs. There's a lot of memories in each one of them songs. Each one of these suits that I wear are made by B&K. They're B&K originals. Each one of them start out about $2,500 to $3,500 a piece. I have around 13 B&K originals and probably another 10 that I had prior to buying B&K. So altogether, I got about 20 suits that I could still perform in. The suits are B&K originals, and although they're expensive, just like Elvis and Aloha from Hawaii, I wanted to give away my cape and my belt. So at the contest on the 20th year, I threw out my cape and my belt, and every one of the Elvis impersonators there were going crazy, saying, man, the guy's lost his mind, you know, he just threw $1,500 out into the audience. But to me, the smiles and the looks on the faces of the people when I threw that cape out into that audience, and when I gave that belt to that special person, that was worth everything in the world to me. I can always buy another cape. I can always buy another belt. The difference I made in that person's life that day, making that person feel special, that's what it was all about. That's what I'm all about. That's what I've always been all about. You know, I've owned my own companies. I owned an ice cream company, I owned school buses, and I owned a computer company. Throughout the 4 decades of playing music, me and the wife have been blessed with 5 boys, who in return have blessed us with 11 grandchildren. So financially, you know, I don't really have any financial struggles. I never have. I've been blessed.
Yeah, we spend the day throwing stones at one another, 'cause I don't think or wear my head same way you do. Uh-huh. Well, I may be common people, but I'm your brother. And when you strike out and try to hurt me, it's hurting you. Oh.
You know, when it comes to harsh criticism, I must say that I really didn't have anything in the later years, but as a child growing up, Elvis was the farthest thing that anybody wanted to actually be portraying. And from the time I was 9 years old, I knew I was going to do Elvis. And I'd tell everybody, oh, I'm going to grow up and I'm going to be Elvis. And they'd ask me in school, you know, what are you going to do? Who are you going to be? I'm going to be an entertainer. You know, what do you do? Well, I sing like Elvis. And of course they'd laugh, and the joke would be on me. Through all the years of school, I'd pretty much say that the joke was on me at the time. But now they come up to my shows and they say, man, I can't believe you knew where you were going, where you were heading, and I'm really proud of you. You made it, man. You've done what you said you were going to do. And that really meant something to me, you know, to have it turned around and come back. But that'd be the only criticism I took. Other than in the late 70s to the early 80s, there was a lot of bad jokes and a lot of stories going around about Elvis. And that was a rough time to be an Elvis tribute artist.
But now, after all these years, today, it's came back around. I run into a schoolmate from school, whether it be grade school or high school. They're actually shaking my hand. They've always got good words to say, and they're always glad to see me. And they're not laughing no more. Because from the very beginning, I've done exactly what I set out to do.
Walk a mile in my shoes. Walk a mile in my shoes.
In the first 20 years, there was a lot of long hours. From 1977 until 1985, we played 6 nights a week, 5 sets a night. So there was a lot of hours.
Walk a mile in my shoes. Walk a mile in my shoes. Yeah, before you accuse, precise and accuse. Walk a mile in my shoes.
In the beginning, there was a lot of long hours of driving to the gigs, setting up equipment, tearing down equipment, band rehearsals 2 and 3 nights a week. Eventually, I had my own tour bus, my own band truck, my own road crew, and then they'd ride to the show and put everything together, and all I'd have to do is just show up. The equipment's there, the band's there, and we put on the show. Throughout the years, it's gotten easier. Now the band and I have been together for over 30 years. I had my share of long hours in the very beginning. For the last 20 years, it's been much better. When it's time to perform, we show up and we do our job.
There are people on reservations out in the ghetto. And brother there, oh, the grace of God, go you and I. Oh, if I only had the wings of a little eagle, don't you know I'd fly to the top of the mountain, and then I'd cry, cry, cry.
When it comes to medical issues, I've had a lot of problems. When I turned 36, I had my first heart attack. From the time I was 36 until I was around 44, I'd had somewhere around 22 casts. I'd had 17 stents put in me, one open heart surgery, one cardioversion, and then in 2011, I was struck with small cell cancer of the lungs, the throat, and the brain. I took 30 chemo treatments and 55 radiation treatments, 10 radiation treatments to the brain. Now that was 2 years of my life I lost, but I fought and I refused to give up. Kept a positive attitude, telling everyone that I would make it back, that I would be able to sing again. Because see, with cancer of the throat, they were saying that my career was over, that I wasn't gonna be able to sing no more. I had to prove them wrong. So I fought and I made it back. In 2014, I was able to come back and do the complete summer concert series and perform my shows. And then this year, 2015, throughout the summer and the concert series, I was able to perform again, had no problems. And I beat cancer, something that wasn't done. One out of three people survived my type of cancer. And I was blessed enough that I won, and I am cancer free. I've been in remission now, going on 4 years. So I've been truly blessed.
Walk a mile in my shoes. Walk a mile in my shoes. Yeah, before you abuse, criticize, and accuse. Walk a mile in my shoes.
When it comes to a toll or a burden, there really never was a toll or a burden to me. I always loved doing it. It's something I wanted to do since I was 4 years old. I never felt like it was a burden. If I had the opportunity to perform, I went and performed. When I played in the clubs and did my years playing in the bars and in the animal clubs coming up, you know, if they let me and the people stayed, I would play till three or four. I never found it as a burden. I just loved to perform. I loved to entertain. And I always felt my best when I'm on stage in front of a live audience.
Walk a mile in my shoes. Walk a mile in my shoes. Yeah, before you abuse, criticize, and accuse. Walk a mile in my shoes.
When it comes to relationships, being an Elvis tribute artist is really hard on relationships. And the Lord knows that women just want to be close to an Elvis impersonator. Now, I experienced all of that being a tribute artist. We're like eye candy for them. So I had my share of women, but there's been quite a few. And I can't say it proudly, but you know, there's been hundreds. I got smart and finally I let them know from the very beginning there was no relationship. It was just, you know, a one-night stand. You know, when you're playing and traveling from town to town, from city to city, from state to state, you know, you got a woman in every town, in every bar, and in most clubs, you know, you end up having two or three. So whoever shows up that night is the lucky woman, is how it worked out for quite a long time. And for Elizabeth to stand by me and put up with all that. My wife, Elizabeth, since 1990, has been my manager. And throughout them years, since 1990, everything I've achieved has really been on behalf of her because she 100% supports me. And that's what I fell in love with. She's always been there. She's always been very supportive of my Elvis tribute show. She's took it serious from day one. And still to today, we always enjoy each other's company and have a good time. It's made our love grow stronger, I think, being in business together throughout the years. And I wouldn't change nothing.
More today than yesterday.
know, it's been said that behind every great man, there's a great woman. Well, I'm here to tell you that philosophy is true. For Elizabeth has been with me through all these years. She's stood by me and been the most supportive person in my life. And tonight's a special night. I'm taking her out to our favorite restaurant to have one of our most favorite meals, Pineapple Paradise.
Sweet boy, I love you more today than yesterday. But I love you less today, less than I will tomorrow. Sweet boy,
walk a mile in my shoes. Walk a mile in my shoes. Any boy you abuse, criticize and accuse. Walk a mile in my shoes.
So which is the most popular feature ever on Across Indiana?
This man, who appeared twice in our first three seasons and became our first bona fide celebrity. Those of you who didn't blink when a certain rock legend drove a bus or sold ice cream probably won't bat an eye at this visual, the king fixing computers.
I'll be lonely. Oh, so lonely.
But even though he's tweaking wires and installing chips, after 19 years, Paul Butler is still, first and foremost, forever Elvis.
Thank you very much. My career really took off after Across Indiana.
I was doing shows like Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, even Sundays. So it was a lot of work making sure all the scarves was made and the suits was all ready and everything. And it was just a constant on the go.
If you're known by the company you keep, then Paul's living room wall shows that he travels in some pretty elite circles.
In 2000, I saw on the TV that the Prime Minister of Tokyo, Japan, was an Elvis impersonator. I asked him if I could send him a copy of my albums, and he said sure, so I sent him a copy of mine, and in return he sent me a copy of his. He really is a really great guy, and he loves Elvis. I met the Cherokee Nation. They actually gave me a Cherokee name. The meaning behind it was the man of many voices.
Now, lest you people at home think we on Across Indiana fool around when we pick our Elvis tribute artist, we'll have you know that Paul is the best on the planet, officially.
In 99, I won the Champion of the World, the Tourist Spirit of Elvis Award.
Now, don't call Paul an Elvis impersonator. What he does is a tribute to the life and music of the king, something he's done, no kidding, since he was only 12 years old.
I'm not going to question it. I'm just going to keep on until he tells me it's too long, tell me to quit.
And who knows, maybe someday he'll leave the pompadour and sunglasses for good, giving rise to a whole new generation of, dare we say it, Paul Butler tribute artists.
Forever, my darling, our love will be true. Always and forever, I'll love only you. Just promise me, darling, your love in return. Red as fire, my soul, dear, forever burn. My heart's at your command, dear, keep love and hold. Making you happy is my desire, dear, loving you is my goal. I'll forever love you for the rest of my days. I'll never part from you or your loving ways. Just promise me, darling, your love in return. May this fire my soul, dear, forever burn. Forever love you for the rest of my days. I'll never part from you or your loving ways. Just promise me, darling, your love in return. May this fire my soul, dear, forever burn. Water glass full of whiskey, women that I never knew too well. Lord, the things I've seen and done, most of which I'd be ashamed to tell. Don't know how it started, but that's what makes a man, I guess. Now I'm holding on to nothing, trying to forget the rest. I'm looking back on my life to see if I can find the pieces. I know some were stolen and some just flew away. I found the bad parts, found all the sad parts, but I guess I threw the best parts away. Away, away. Playing the bars, playing like a star, anything to get a name. Carrying on, living on songs my friends chose for me to sing. I'm looking back on my life to see if I can find the pieces. I know some were stolen and some just flew away. I found the bad parts, found all the sad parts, but I guess I threw the best parts away. Away, away. All the pieces of my life are everywhere and everywhere. All the pieces of my life are everywhere and everywhere. And the ones I miss the most, you and you know who. Yeah, the pieces of my life, God help me find the pieces. Yeah, the pieces of my life, Lord help me find. Yeah, the pieces of my life, God help me find the pieces.
Taking care of business by teaching Tots the laws of Elvis.
And remember, always be good to your mama.
That's next.
MCL, the desserts alone are enough to bring most people back.
Oh, man.
MCL, it cooks.
You're probably as tired of Elvis impersonators as we are, but Paul Butler isn't a copycat. He's an original, a bus driver who thinks kids should learn more on their way to school than just dirty jokes. George Ciccarone took a ride with the King of the Road.
Another morning in Anderson, Indiana. But for the kids who hop aboard this bus, the day begins with a little Elvis 101.
Are y'all ready to go to school?
Yeah!
We're just about ready to take you.
His name is Paul Butler, mild-mannered school bus driver. But about 2 days a week, he straps on his outfit for a lesson in elementary Elvis.
We're heading out.
The whole idea is just keep the memory of the man Elvis. And then it's to make the kids happy, to give them a smile, give them something to laugh about, and give them something to talk about. I feel like if I can make them smile, then I've done my good deed for the day.
I bet you make them smile.
Oh, yeah.
I believe in town, baby. I believe in town, sure. Oh, and you won't be bothered with me hanging around this door, but that's all right.
Like so many other Elvis impersonators around the country, about 20 years ago, he says he was called upon by a mystical force to dedicate a portion of his life to the King. Now in Anderson, anyways, he is the King of the Road.
Elvis! 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 How are we all doing today,
Elvis? Hi, Elvis!
Along his stop, forget about the Ninja Turtles, never mind the new kids on the block. It's perfectly predictable that these little people prefer Presley.
Give me five. Thank you, baby.
Well, you're probably wondering how this whole thing started, right? Well, one Halloween about 15 years ago, Paul for Charity decided to do a grave impersonation of the King. Now, let's face it. Most of these kids don't have the slightest idea who Elvis Presley was. And that's just what gets Paul all riled up, providing the inspiration for him to dress up and teach these kids something more than just their ABCs, but also their ease.
When you see the little young smile, it's really overwhelming.
Y'all remember to be good in school today. Have a good day. And remember, always be good to your mama. See you, youngins. Y'all be good. We'll see you, youngins.
In Anderson, as throughout the Hoosier State, one would not be surprised to see one of these big yellow babies rolling down the road, taking kids to and from school. But on one particular route, there's a bus driver who has the good citizens of Anderson all shook up.
Thank you.
I'm all shook up.
Mm-hmm. When I wear the full attire, it puts off a good image to them, and they get all excited about it, and everybody looks, and everybody's talking, and everybody's staring.
Meet Paul Butler, bus driver, Elvis impersonator.
I'm all shook up.
Mm-hmm. My mother bought me an album, and it was Elvis's Golden Records, and I liked it because all the Golden Records on it with his faces in it. I didn't know nothing about him, and my mother said, I'll buy the album for you, but you gotta memorize every song on that album. Our family was a music family. We played music every weekend, so it was just natural to memorize the words to the songs. And through the years, my voice just kept turning more and more like his. From one record to another, I just kept liking him more and more.
Paul Butler began his career impersonating Elvis as a wiry 13-year-old, armed only with fake sideburns and a pair of blue suede shoes. As a nightclub performer, Paul has portrayed his idol, and while his unique relationship with Elvis may be an intriguing story in and of itself, Paul's story goes even further, from the unusual to the extra special.
Most school bus drivers, when you ask a student about the school bus driver, they call him a crab apple, you know, or an old grouch, you know, this or that. You know, you ask my kids about me, they're going to come back with a great response because we always have a good time.
Paul sees himself simply as a big kid, taking a fun and unusual approach to the daily grind. But to his young charges, he is something much more. To them, in the immortal words of country singer Roger Miller, Paul is truly the king of the road.
Trailer for sale or rent, room to let the distance. No phone, no pool, no pet. Ain't got no cigarette, but 2 hours of pushing broom by the 8x12 4-bit room. I'm a man of means by no means, king of the road.
How about us all sing a little song?
Ain't on a bloodhound dog, a crying all time. Ain't on a bloodhound dog, a crying all time. You ain't never called rabbit and you ain't no friend of mine. You ain't on a bloodhound dog, a crying all time.
Now, whether Paul's young fans are touched with a strange type of burning love for Elvis's music doesn't really matter to Paul. What does matter is the special philosophy he continually presents to them.
The message that I try to give the kids is that to keep a smile on their face, they're going to get through life a lot easier than a lot of the other kids that doesn't have this philosophy.
He is doing it his own special way, starting off children's days with smiles on their faces and songs in their hearts. And while this earth may only know one Elvis Presley, the world could certainly welcome many more Paul Butler.
The greatest thing about being a school bus driver is these little kids watching them from this high, and now they're this high looking at me. You know, 7 years these kids have grown up. I mean, and they're coming up to me going, hey, I remember you, you know, and you really were nice to me, and I'll never forget it. And the little kids, they come running up to me and hug me when they see me. So, you know, there's nothing, no amount of money or nothing in the world that could replace that, you know. If I died tonight, I couldn't complain. You know, I've lived a great life. I've done some things that nobody's ever done before, and people would just love to do. So I can't complain. And that's what proves to me that the philosophy is true, you know. If you want something, you got to give a little. And if you give, you will receive. And that's what the magic word does.
But not too big around. I'm a man of means by no means. If we were talking, we might come on.
So, in case the subject of Elvis ever comes up, and you know it will, you tell him that Elvis is alive and well and driving a school bus in Anderson, Indiana.
Thank you very much.
I love it.
The only ambition I had growing up was I wanted to one day be able to walk up to Elvis Presley and sing for him and have him go, you're all right, kid. You know, because I never thought that Elvis was going to die. That was never entered my mind. And I don't think it did anybody's, matter of fact. We just never thought of that in that way. And so I thought, you know, I had plenty of time. One day I'd be able to do that. My whole reason for doing it was to keep this memory alive and to make people smile, you know. And I just wanted, I hope and pray that someday, you know, that I can achieve it to where people will remember me for doing a good job. And that's my ultimate goal. If I can put a smile on someone's face and make them forget about their troubles or the things that are happening in their life for just a short 1 or 2 hours, I figure every day, you know, if you can make somebody smile, then you've made the world a little bit better.
Can you talk about why you like to
call yourself a tribute artist? To me, well, there's only one Elvis Presley, and it's impossible to impersonate, but it's very easy to do a tasteful tribute to him. And that's what I try to portray. I don't ever claim that I can be as good as Elvis in any way. But if I can remind you of what Elvis was like, some of the phrases that he mimicked on stage, if I can take you back to a time that you remember Elvis and put a smile on your face, then I've done my job. And that's what being a tribute artist is just reminding you of the great entertainer Elvis Presley.
About the Elvis Spirit Award.
In 1999, they created the True Spirit of Elvis Award. This award was designed and originated for people who have the Elvis Spirit off stage as well as on stage. And I'm very proud that I was the first recipient to ever receive that award. And to me, that's worth all the money in the world, you know. The whole idea, as I said before, a tribute artist wants to be remembered and wants to be able to know in his heart that he's done a good job. And when they gave me that award and I received it, it was almost like Elvis going, "You're all right, kid. You know, you're pretty good." And that was my dream. So to be able to receive it from the images of Elvis, it was a great honor.
Give me a song.
I'll remember the summer.
There you go. What a guy.
If I could go back, I wouldn't change a thing, because everything that's happened to me has brought me to where I am today. I've been very blessed. I've done movies, I've done commercials, I'm in several books. I won the Spirit of Elvis Award.
Oh, everybody, I feel my temperature rising. Yeah, I, it's burning through to my soul. Song of the choir, you light my morning sky, burning love. Ooh, 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 I feel my temperature rising, 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 rising. Tell me I'm blaming, I must be 109. Yeah, burning, 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 nothing can cool me. Yeah, I'm just not turning the smoke. Well, I feel fine, yeah. Kisses are left behind, like a sweet song of the choir. You light my morning sky, burning love.
Oh yeah. Tonight. Cause I just can't miss no good luck charm like you. Come on and be my little good luck charmer, you sweet delight. I want a good luck charm hanging on my tonight, 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 tonight. Say, only fools
don't toss how I see it. Real sweet, you got everything at home. It's all needs, oh baby. Whoa, 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 baby. Yeah, hey, baby. I have some fun tonight. Well, I saw Uncle John, a bald-headed Sally. He saw Mary coming and he jumped back in the alley, oh baby. Whoa, 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 baby. Yeah, hey, baby. I have some fun tonight. Well, everything's alright. We're gonna have some fun tonight. Everything's alright. We're gonna have some fun tonight.
It's basically all for the love of Elvis. And that's basically how I sum myself up. I'm a tribute artist, but I basically am doing it for the love of Elvis. First and last.
Difference I made in that person's life that day, making that person feel special. That's what it was all about.
I think Paul is wonderful. He looks just like Elvis. Since I can remember, I've just wanted to meet Elvis, and he's the closest thing. He acts like Elvis. And I came all the way from Phoenix just to see him this one night, and it's been magical. He made my dream come true.
Your heart and soul, if I can dream. Live from Memphis, Gospel 99, Christmas. And we're all yours.
He just threw the cape, I grabbed it.
That's what it was all about. That's what I'm all about. That's what I've always been all about.
Ladies and gentlemen, they're waiting for the most coveted ticket in show business. Ladies and gentlemen, live from the International Hotel in Las Vegas, Nevada, it's Elvis Alive.
CL, the desserts alone are enough to bring most people back.
Oh, man.
MCL, it cooks.
Thank you. Good evening and welcome to the show. If you haven't figured it out by now, we're filming tonight. So don't let the lights and cameras stir you. But they are hot, I tell you for sure. Something like this. Are you all having a good time today? Well, thank you so much for being here, you terrific guys. We got a little song in 1972 that's on top of the church for 8 straight weeks. A little song called Suspicious Minds, and it goes something like this.
Well, since my baby left me, I've Thank you.
like to thank each and every one of you for coming out and being here with us today. Have y'all had a good time? Until we meet you again, may God bless you. Adios. This is our tribute song to the King of Rock and Roll. I hope you love it.
Like gold of autumn leaves around my feet. I touch them and they burst apart with sweet memories. Sweet memories of holding hands and red bouquets and twilights trimmed in purple haze and laughing eyes and simple ways and quiet nights and gentle days with you. Memories press between the pages of my mind. Memories sweeten through the ages just like wine. Memories, memories of holding hands and red bouquets and twilights trimmed in purple haze and laughing eyes and simple ways and quiet nights and gentle days with you. Memories press between the pages of my mind. Memories sweetened through the ages just like wine. Memories, memories, sweet memories.